Hey there. Is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible because it's the divinely inspired word of God, and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate, and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today. And we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church. Hey there! Is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible, because it's the divinely inspired Word of God, and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate, and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today. And we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church.
Welcome to worship. I am Pastor Steve Broad, and on behalf of the entire congregation here at the United Methodist Church of Wilton, we want to welcome you to our virtual worship service today. During this season of Lent, we are looking at places of the Passion. Today, we are standing here at the top of the Mount of Olives, a large mountain for that region that overlooks the city of Jerusalem. As it spreads out behind us. Off to that direction is the city of Bethany that we talked about last week. But this entire widespread mountain is one that allows us to get a feeling of what it was like in Jesus' time as he walked from Bethany to Jerusalem to crest this top where we're at now and to see the city laid out in front of him. So as we prepare to worship Christ today, as we light our candle in our virtual sanctuary, I suggest that you light a candle in your place of worship. Turn the lights down a little bit, maybe turn the music up, find a comfortable spot so that you can sing and pray and worship God in your own unique way, in your own spot. So as we light the Christ's candle, and as we sing our way into worship, as I have decided to follow Jesus, may our hearts and minds and souls meet together with Christ on this day.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. The world behind cross before me, the world behind me, the cross before me, the world behind me, the cross before me, no turning back, no turning back, though none go with me, still I will follow.
On this third Sunday of Lent, let us join in the call to worship. During this season of Lent, may we be willing to enter the places of the Passion.
Gather us in and invite us to take the journey, O God.
As we gather to hear the familiar stories of Lent, may we encounter them in new ways.
Give us receptive hearts and minds, O God.
Let us go to the Mount of Olives, where Jesus prayed and reflected upon his suffering.
As we go to the Mount of Olives, let us worship the one who suffered to give us life.
Our first praise song. Now that we have lit the candle, we have declared our call to worship, is I Stand Amazed. Standing amazed here on this hilltop. So let us sing.
The Nazarene, and wonder how he could love me, a sinner condemned unclean. How marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. He took my sins and my sorrows.
Praise song, Glorious Day, allows us to celebrate that today is Sunday. Every Sunday is a little Easter. Today we celebrate the resurrection of Christ on this glorious day. So let us join our voices together through the airwaves, through the digitalness, and allow us to praise God.
One day when heaven was filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin. He dwelt among men, my example is he. One day they led him up Calvary's mountain. One day they nailed him to die on a tree. Suffering, anguish, despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is he. The hands that healed nations stretched out on a tree and took the nails for me. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. And rising, he justified.
Stone rolled away from the door.
could not hold him. The grave could not keep him from rising again. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising, he justified. Sins far away. Rising, he justified.
As we come to our time of joys and concern, if you have a joy or concern that you would like to add to the church prayer list, I would encourage you to add it to the chat section to the side or down below in the comments section. This week we have had our hearts quite tugged on as we have learned of the death of Cheryl Denny, Bruce and Sally Walker's daughter. That funeral will be tomorrow in Iowa City. You can go to the link on our Facebook page and watch it live streamed from the funeral home. But keep Bruce and Sally in your prayers, her husband Wayne and her sister Sarah, as well as the rest of the family, as they remember and as they mourn and as we take a time to celebrate the life that was so short but so bright. We want to continue to keep in our prayers those that are dealing with illnesses. As Don Hartman continues to recover at home, and Diane Budding, Marcia Hessler, Carolyn Tharp, who is in the hospital undergoing a new DNA treatment, to keep her in your prayers as they start this new process. We have a praise moment that Rick Steffens has tests have shown no cancer. So there is a moment of prayers answered and hearts relieved. We want to continue to keep in our prayers those that are dealing with COVID-19, like Don and Mary Timmerman, the pastors at Nichols and Cedar Valley, those who are still recovering from the long-term effects, those that are coming out of dealing with that issue and that hardship. We want to continue to pray for those who are giving out and getting the vaccines. We want to continue to allow God to watch over those who have yet to be vaccinated, to protect them and to keep them, to be with the nurses, the doctors, the teachers, the caregivers, all the frontline people. So with all of that in mind, let us take this time to join together in our unison prayer.
Let us pray.
O Lord, on the night before your suffering, you sang a hymn with your disciples and went to the Mount of Olives to pray. It was for our sake that you took on suffering. Words can never express our deep gratitude for your choice to go to the cross for us. Forgive us for the sins we have committed in thought, word, and deed. Grant us healing and new life and make us whole. Amen.
Lord, I thank you and praise you for all that you've done for us, all that you are doing for us. Lord, I ask that you continue to pour out your Holy Spirit upon us. Lord, we ask that you be with all of those concerns, named and unnamed. Those that are dealing with issues of the heart, mind, body, and soul, Lord, help us to reach out to them, to love them. Lord, allow us to be extra loving and caring. Lord, help us to reach out to the least and the lost, those that are dealing with issues of mental health and physical health, lack of or inadequate housing, loss of income, those that are dealing with abuse and addiction. Lord, help us to be your emissaries, to stand in the way. Lord, we ask that you continue to be with the nurses and the doctors as they treat and heal members of our church, members of our family. Lord, we ask that you continue to watch over Wayne and Bruce and Sally and Sarah. Lord, I ask that you be with my niece and her fiancé as they deal with their cancer, with Carolyn and Marcia, Diane. Lord, we praise and thank you for the good news for Rick. But Lord, we just know that there are so many more that are hurting from bumps, bruises, falls, broken hearts, minds that are distracted. Lord, pour out your mercy upon those who are standing in harm's way. Help them to feel your love and your guidance, your protection. So Lord, today, we prepare ourselves to be what you need us to be in this time, in this place. So Lord, come and sit with us now in a time of silence. Instruct us, show us, teach us and lead us. Lord, come, be with us now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for holding us, caring for us, forgiving us, helping us to see the error of our ways. Lord, help us to continue upon the path that you have placed us. So, Lord, we now come to you with that prayer of praise that you taught your disciples so long ago.
Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Those who have prayed that prayer, those who have opened up their hearts, those who have allowed God to wash over them, God is preparing you. God is preparing us. God is getting this church ready to bring about God's kingdom right here where God has planted us today. So with that, let us praise God. Let us continue to sing and to reflect and respond to that prayer time with this song.
Isn't the name of Jesus wonderful? Isn't the name of Jesus wonderful? All the world can come to him and have their sins removed. Isn't the name of Jesus wonderful? Isn't the name of Jesus beautiful? And isn't the name of Jesus beautiful? Son of God and Word of us, lover of my soul, isn't the name of Jesus beautiful? Eternal King, you will reign forever, and we will see the glories of your name. Be lifted high, so all the world will see. Your name is all we need. Your name is all we need.
Isn't the name of Jesus powerful? Isn't the name of Jesus powerful? Chains are broken when it's spoken. Every knee will bow. Isn't the name of Jesus powerful? Eternal King, you will reign forever, and we will sing the glories of your name. Be lifted high, so all the world will see. Your name is all we need. Your name is all we need. There is freedom in the name. There's healing in the name. There is power in the name. Salvation in the name. There is life in the name. There is no other name but Jesus.
Today's scripture lesson takes us all the way to Holy Week, right at the end of the Last Supper, right at the end of that time when Jesus has washed the disciples' feet, broken bread with them, and given them the blood, the body, the sacrament of communion. So hear these words as they leave that place.
The Gospel of Matthew, chapter 26, verses 30 through 35. When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you. Jesus said to him, Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. Peter said to him, Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you. And so said all the disciples. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
We have special music today. Mike Hine and Laura Nouse have worked together to have a special song on this, the first Sunday in March. The song is, You Never Let Go. I hope you enjoy this. They did a great job.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. And I will fear no evil.
Oh, no, never.
welcome to the Mount of Olives. This spot that you see around me is the northern edge of the Mount of Olives. It's an olive grove that has been preserved by a church so that you get a sense of what the mountain might have been like at that time of Jesus versus the built up and more modernized sizes. So let's go for a walk. As Jesus met with his disciples, as they left the garden, as they headed to a time of prayer at the Mount of Olives, this was a place where they passed through on a regular basis, going from Bethany to Jerusalem. It was a place that would have been cool, relaxing. From what you can see around me, there were, like them, there was plenty of shade if you needed it, but yet open enough for a breeze to blow through. The olive trees that you see as we walk along here, that's about the way that they would have been planted. A little bit of space between them so that they could get sunlight all the way around so that the olives could grow and ripen. They're a short tree so that they can be picked from the ground or reached with a small ladder or by climbing up inside them. It would have been a very orderly place. But it was a place where Jesus and his disciples, after having left the upper room, came to as a place of quiet, a place of solitude. I'll tell you that as I walked this path, as I walked this path originally, I couldn't hear traffic. I could just hear birds. I could hear the wind blowing. It allowed me to imagine what it might have been like 2,000 years ago as Jesus walked to the garden, as he walked to that place where they could stop, allow the meal to digest, to take time to pray. But today's story tells us that it was a little bit more tense, I think, than what they planned. For when they got there, Jesus informed them that he was about to be turned over. He was about to be sent away. His time had come. But Peter said, "That's not going to happen. I'll never abandon you. I will die with you." And of course, that's where Jesus tells them that, "Peter, I'm sorry, but by morning, after the rooster crows three times, you will have denied me three times." And Jesus said, "That will not happen, Lord." And in this version, actually all the rest of the disciples even say, "That's not going to happen. We will not abandon you or deny you." But we all know the story. And we're going to look at that a little bit closer as another place of the passion. But tonight, in this Mount of Olives, this place that Jesus has walked through and tread through, has been a part of his ministry between Bethany and Jerusalem, has been a common place. He has to inform his disciples that life is going to change, and it's going to change dramatically. Part of me thinks he's probably hoping that they didn't forget the lessons that he had just taught them at the upper room about remembering the sacrifice, carrying that sacrament forward. But the good news is, we all know from what I often call our helicopter perspective on history, they didn't forget that lesson. They took that lesson and taught the whole world the sacrifice of Jesus. They remembered what happened that night. They used it as part of their motivation to continue to move forward in a way that brought glory and honor to God. And that's the way it can be for us. There are times when all of us, at some point in our lives, have probably denied Jesus, whether it was probably maybe not necessarily verbally, outwardly about the fact that, you know, I don't believe in Jesus, but it might have been more along the fact that we made a moral or ethical choice that would not have been in line with the teachings of Jesus. And we came to realize later that we had made a huge mistake, either because of the consequences that came with that decision or by our own examination. And that is what happens with these disciples. I love the story later on in John, clear off in the 21st chapter, 21:12 is actually my favorite verse because it says, Jesus said, come, eat breakfast. But that's in the midst of the context of Jesus after his resurrection, meeting them at the Sea of Galilee while they were all fishing and gathered there. And he brought Peter to the shore and made Peter confess that he would feed Jesus' flock. He made him do it three times to make up for the three times that he betrayed him. And Peter would go on to live and to love just like Jesus had taught him, being with the flock. So today, as we traverse this Mount of Olives, as we look at the landscape around us, as we realize that God has a place of passion for us, maybe not quite so spectacular or historical as this Mount of Olives, but could be just as much of a passion right here in our region, right here in Iowa. God can be using us to bring about God's glory, to help us, to spread God's word. So today, on this first Sunday in March, as the weather gets warmer, as we get through this pandemic and we can be more together, it allows us to proclaim God's good news. Just like the disciples eventually got to do after their time of being scattered and separated and isolated, we can be the same way. So let us pray. Lord, I thank you and praise you for these, your people, that you have placed in my midst, even if it is by digital internet connection, that you were using them to bring about your glory wherever they are at. So Lord, pour out your blessings upon us. Allow us to claim our place of passion to bring about your good news, to bring about your kingdom. Amen. We come to that time of our worship service to take up our gifts and our tithes, a time where we can give back to God a portion of what God has gifted us. I realize that during this time of pandemic and this time of layoffs and furloughs that not everybody has the capability to give, and that's okay. Take care of yourself, take care of your family. There are plenty of people taking care of the church during this time for us to get through. For those of you that would like to contribute to the mission and ministry of our church, there are several ways that you can do that. You can write a check, mail it to the church at Post Office Box 57, Wilton, Iowa, 52778. Or you can go to our website, www.umcofwilton.org. Click on the button for online giving. We have partnered with Vanco to make it safe and secure for you to give online. At this time, I want to thank you for all the support that you have given our church. If any of you are in need of assistance, please give me a call. I have funds for helping out members of the church. As these gifts come from all of us, let us join our voices together to dedicate these gifts to God's mission and ministry. Let us pray.
O Lord, you have given us your word for a light to shine upon our path. Grant us so to meditate on that word and to follow its teaching. Bless these gifts that they might help to provide light to shine upon your mission and ministry to the world. Help us to live with what you give us and to give away what we have in abundance. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Announcement time. We have trustees tomorrow night, Monday, March 8th at 7 p.m. via Zoom to look at what we need to do to continue to get the church ready for this exciting time of reopening and coming back together more and more in person. This next week, I would remind you that we do have devotions on Wednesday and Thursday at 3 p.m. on YouTube and Facebook. And, of course, worship on Sunday at 10, 15, and 7. I do want to remind you and let you know that the mission team has been very active. They are so thrilled with your response to the Appalachian Seed Project. They have come up with close to or right around $800 total of either in-kind seeds or in cash that will be being sent out to the two locations in Appalachia. Should fill several gardens with produce this summer. They are so happy and they are so thankful for your pouring out of blessing. I also want to remind you that we have our Lenten offering, and watch this short clip of a reminder of what we're doing this Lenten season.
I'm here today representing the mission team. Lent is upon us now, and we always have a special offering for the season. This year, the mission team has chosen Feed the Children.
Feed the Children trucks crisscross the country, delivering boxes of urgently needed food and essentials to feed America's children. It begins with volunteers sorting the products and packing those valuable boxes.
If you can help with donations, Feed the Children will be available as a listing on Vanco. You can also write a check to church and on the memo line indicate Feed the Children or Lenten offering. Either one is fine. And if you cannot help financially, that's perfectly all right. The gift of your prayers is a most significant donation.
So now that you've been brought up to date, I would remind you to keep watching your Facebook, keep watching your email, keep listening to your voicemails that I may send to you throughout the week for any important updates that'll be happening for the church or our community. Please join me in our responsive benediction. Confess to the Lord your God,
for God is merciful.
Repent to the Lord your God,
for God will hear our remorse.
Ask for mercy from the Lord your God,
for God is forgiving.
Receive the grace of God,
for God abounds in steadfast love.
Be reconciled to God, for Christ took the journey to the cross to bring us back to God. Let Christ forgive you, give you life, and satisfy your soul. And all God's people said,
Amen.
As we go out, as we sing our way out into the world, as we take the light of Christ from our sanctuary out into the world, let us join together praising God's name, Jesus Messiah.
Came sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing, love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom from Messiah, Lord of all.
given and poured out, all for love.
The whole earth trembled and the veil was torn.
Love so amazing.
Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah.
Blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel,
the rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah.